What up, what up, what up, everybody? I am The Malizel, and this is my channel. And this is like going to be a really sad video. I'm going to be deleting my channel. This is going to be my last video on this channel, and I've decided that I'm not going to make the YouTube videos anymore because, you know, I'm getting told too often that my videos are unprofessional and that, you know, they're uncredible and that, you know, they're hindering me from getting, you know, an actual job. And, you know, I've been thinking about this for a couple of months. I really enjoyed making content for you guys. I really enjoyed, you know, this like year and a half of, you know, entertaining you and making some of you really happy, which is why y'all fell for this shit. Fuck out of here. I ain't fucking deleting my channel. Like, wait, nah. Delete my channel where? Delete my channel where? I'm gonna be here forever and ever and ever and ever, okay? This video is going to be the start of my new series called Shit Talk Sessions. So when I first started my YouTube channel, I really wanted to do music reviews and fashion videos. Well, that's what I originally wanted to do. However, as time went by, that shit just didn't happen. And every time someone asks me what I do on my channel, my answer is usually, I talk shit. That's just what I do on my channel. Like, I do. That's what I do. So I was like, yo, like, I should just have sessions where I just talk about shit. Like, cause I be having so much shit to talk about, y'all. So much shit to talk about. So many things be happening to me. People say things to me and I just be like, yo, I want to make a video about this. But like, I don't know what genre this could be in. Like, I don't know where it's gonna go. Like, I'm a very organized person. I like to put my stuff in playlists. So I'm just like, damn, like, I can't talk about this because I don't know where that shit gonna go. Like, wait, like, where this shit gonna go? So I was like, yo, like, I'm gonna make a fucking series on it. A series on it. So what prompted this video in particular is a text message that I received recently from a professor of mine. I have been told numerous times that my channel is going to hinder me in the future from getting jobs and getting opportunities, etc., etc. First, I heard this from my youth group. I am public relations officer for my youth group. I'm historian and I'm also their music director. And you know, they were telling me this was like about a year ago, they told me that, you know, my channel is inappropriate because, you know, I curse on my channel, this, that, and the third. And I mean, okay, that's appropriate coming from a church. However, even though they've said this to me, they still do support my channel and a lot of them still watch my channel and a lot of them still do whatever they can to support any and everything I do. However, recently, I received a text message from a professor. I'm not going to say any names. However, this text message pissed me off to the gods. Now, usually when people tell me to stop cursing or stop doing this, stop doing that, stop being so vulgar, why gotta do this, why gotta do that, I just look at them like, you don't have to watch my shit. Point blank period. If you do not like what I do, if you're not in agreement in anything that I do, don't agree with it, don't watch me. If you do not fuck with me, don't fuck with me. Like, it's very simple. It bothers my soul that people find it necessary to tell me the obvious. Yes, I know me cursing on my channel can potentially hinder me from getting employed. Yes, I know that some of my content is a little bit vulgar. Yes, I know children watch me, but with all due respect, if you were raised correctly, you should know that you should not be repeating everything you see. You should be raised well enough to have the common sense not to repeat bad things or do things that other people do. At the end of the day, I personally do not believe in peer pressure. Everyone does what they want to do no matter what. That's how I feel. Regardless of if you were influenced or not, you did it because you wanted to do it. I am not concerned about nobody's dirty ass kids watching me and repeating and doing whatever the fuck that I do, because that's not my damn business. I am not here to be a role model. I am not here to be anyone's savior. I'm not here to water myself down for anyone. And if you have a problem with me, then do not watch me. It is very simple. I started my channel like years ago. I hated it. I hated my channel so much for the simple reason because I didn't like myself. I watered myself down. Like, I was very boring. Like, I really got on the camera and I was like, hello everyone, my name's Ivana and today's video is going to be, I'm not like that, bruh. Like, that's just not how I talk. Like, I talk like this. I can turn it on and I can turn it off. Like, that's just the way I am, but this is how I am on a regular basis. So when I finally came back to YouTube the third time, I decided I was gonna be myself. No ands, ifs, or buts. I am not going to filter myself. I am not going to be any different from what I am in real person. If you meet me, you will know. Like, I'm really like this. I'm actually worse in person, actually. Like, I feel like I kind of do tone it down for the camera a little bit. But this is how I am. So when I decided to really come back on YouTube, that was my main thing. I was like, I'm gonna be whoever the fuck I am no matter what. And I really thought about it. I was like, yo, like, me being who the fuck I am really may deter me from getting certain jobs. So I decided, okay, I'm just not going to broadcast that I have a channel to like employers. So that's why my real name really wasn't on my channel at first. So I had put it on hold and I was like, okay, I need to come up with something. So I came up with The Mademoiselle, okay? That's another story in itself where I came up with the Mademoiselle thing. But all in all, I never wanted to tell anyone I had a channel. I was very like, about telling people I had a channel. I was like, I never really wanted to, because I was like, I curse on here and I talk about shit that, like, you know, I always thought like, yo, this shit isn't something I should be talking about. However, over the years, I started realizing like, yo, people would come up to me, okay? People would come up to me and they would tell me that I inspired them. People would come up to me and tell me that they watch my videos and I say the things that they don't want to say. You know, things that they're afraid to say. And it's funny because that's what my goal is. I am here to say shit that most people are not going to say because they're afraid to say it. And you know, like, when people started coming up to me and they were like, yeah, like, you inspired me. Like, I really fucks with you. Like, you really shit. That's when I was like, you know what? Fuck it. So then one day, a Bloomfield College representative from the marketing department came up to me and she was like, oh my God, I love your videos. Like, your videos are so great. Like, the marketing department should hire you. I'm just looking at her like, what? Like, she gave me a box of pizza, everything. Like, she comes to me, a box of pizza and all. And I'm just like, like, I ain't know Bloomfield was watching my videos, but then I kind of did, because if you type in Bloomfield College, I'm one of the first people that pop up, right? So I'm just like, okay, good shit. Like, but seriously, y'all, seriously, it's been brought to my attention that some people feel like my videos are unprofessional and uncredible. Bitch, what? I was greeted with a very annoying ass motherfucking text message the other day. Really pissed me off. When I tell y'all pissed me off, pissed me off. My professor and my roommate's about to interrupt this video. So, if y'all hear the door, please ignore it. My professor hits me up. I'm not gonna say what kind of professor, I'm not gonna say who professor, I'm not even gonna say nothing. I'm just gonna say one of my professors hit me up at 4 in the morning, I might add, saying that basically, you know what, let's get their message and let's read their message because this shit is hilarious. Like, it's funny, but it's not funny at the same damn time. I woke up the other day with my professor texting me, yes, my professor has my number, saying this. I got a disturbing email from Professor Blank. She sent me a link to one of your YouTube segments that is slated live on WBCR, and you use profanity. While I realized these words were not going on the air, Keep that in mind. We don't want WBCR associated with such language. Please either remove that clip or the reference to WBCR. After both of us sent in recommendations for you, this is not an professional, sorry professor, a professional. Professor Blank is not happy, and that puts me and the radio station's future and reputation in jeopardy. Please advise. So, I mean, fair enough. The other day, actually no, about a week or so ago, if you guys are watching, I did a live stream and I was live on the air. Well, actually I wasn't live yet. I think I was preparing to be live, but I wasn't live yet. Or I was in between being live, I was probably just playing music. I did not curse on air, like he clearly said. I was cursing in the live stream. I'm sure one of y'all said some shit and I was just like, ha bitch, like ha. Wasn't that serious, okay? So you know what, I understood. I was mad that this text was sent at 4:30 a.m. However, I understood, you know? So I said, I meant to say didn't, but it says I did use profanity on air. I was just on the, I just used it on the live stream itself. I deleted the clip, however. So I said I didn't use profanity, you know? Just used it in my live stream, because it's my live stream. It's my social media, eh? Let's say the conversation could have ended right there. You could just said thank you. Now this is where I got mad. Ivana, as always mentioned in class, announcers should never use profanity on the radio, terrestrial, or internet, or anything to do with WBCR. Those who do on other internet stations have management approval. Any profanity connected to WBCR would result in losing all on-air privileges. It could also result in the demise of the station. This includes music played live or taped on WBCR. Only clean versions can be played. What you do on your own personal social media sites is up to you, but potential employers and universities would not consider your work as credible or professional, and you can't connect it to the college or university. Thanks for deleting the clip. I also assume your text mean I didn't use profanity, not I did. Yeah, I said I didn't, but you know, typos, yeah. My work is incredible and unprofessional? Wow, wait, I'm sorry, this shit got me. First of all, because y'all know I got mad, and y'all know I respond to that shit. A lady from the marketing department a couple months ago came up to me and handed me a box of pizza. I was happy as hell. Handed me a box of pizza. She was like, oh my God, you're the one from YouTube, right? I watch your videos. Like, I really love them. I was watching your Move-In Day vlog. Cursed the hell out of my life in that video. Shit, I had the fight on the quad in that video. Congratulated me on my channel and told me that the marketing department of the school should hire me. Uncredible? Unprofessional? I mean, I guess. Call it what you want, right? I said was not aware of the WBCR connection to my channel would make the station jeopardized. I apologize for that. I am also aware of my personal media sites possibly hindering me from employment. However, it's my personal socials and that is what I do on there. I use my socials to broadcast myself and make money from me being myself. What you see is what you get, and that is broadcasted across all of my platforms that I have grown organically on my own. I am not going to dumb down my personality and risk getting exposed in the long run for being something I am not. Whether you or any of the other professors agree with it or not, with all due respect, it has taken me very far and in fact helped me land jobs and become a paid content creator. My work is very credible and I know when to be professional and when to just be myself. Furthermore, the school has seen my channel and actually thought it brought good traffic to the school, and they applauded me for it. Like I stated earlier, I did remove the clip, and in the future, I will make sure I don't live stream or curse when I'm mentioning WBCR. I also said I did use profanity on my live stream, but not on air. The professor then replies, I knew that's what you meant. Thanks for clearing this up. Enjoy your day. I appreciate your attention to this matter. It's important. Like I said, what you do on your sites is your business. I only offered my advice. Why did you just leave it? Why are you still talking? I said, I appreciate your advice. However, I created a platform for myself, and in doing that, I have become economically free and dependent on no one. I am proud of myself for that. and no one will be able to take that away from me, especially when you and many others giving me advice aren't helping me get a job. I understand where you are coming from and I will keep it in mind. Now, when I said this, I knew this would make the professor upset. This is the thing that I don't understand. A lot of people that have a lot of shit to say are not gonna help you do any better. I don't care what you say to me, okay? But make sure if you wanna say something to me that you're actually offering me something valid or something better. Do not tell me what I already know. Yeah, you shouldn't curse on your channel. An employer can see it. No shit, man, I'm 22. I mean, I look like a kid. I'm 4'11". I look like a baby, but I'm not fucking stupid, okay? I thought about all of this stuff before I started my channel. So that's why I started making videos again the third time around. And I was like, yo, I will vow to be myself. I'm not dumbing myself down for no one. Shit, even at that, I feel like I'm worse in person. If y'all think I'm crazy here, like, I'm very bad in person. I think I turn it down for the camera still, okay? I'm kind of crazy now. Well, this is how I am. Seriously, but this is not the point. The point is, I'm not stupid and I don't appreciate people telling me the obvious, like, get to the point. Like, at the end of the day, I feel like the conversation should have ended at me deleting the clip. You could have just been like, thank you, have a good day. But now you wanna attack my platform. Now you wanna tell me that I'm unprofessional and my work is incredible. Well, I'm sorry, I guess all 2,000 of you are not credible. I guess the 27K I got on Twitter is not credible. I guess the 10.9K I have on Instagram is not credible. Clearly I bought y'all. Clearly, maybe I just bought y'all motherfuckers. Maybe y'all don't exist. Maybe all these views right now, I just bought them. Y'all all robots. Clearly, that's what the fuck y'all, that's how I took that shit. Don't ever come from my platform. You can come for me. Don't ever call my work incredible. Don't ever call my work unprofessional. That shit makes me mad. At the end of the day, everybody curse, B. People curse every day, B. It's not that serious. And with that being said, I understand, yes, this is my preference. I ain't gonna say this person ain't teach me nothing. I'm not gonna say this person isn't a valuable person to my life. But at the end of the day, you're not helping me find a job. Point blank. The point is, there's a lot of hypocrisy going on. There's a lot of professors who play the favorite game. They'll do things like exclude us. Like, they'll put some kids in group chats to do special things. They'll do things like invite certain kids to certain trips that they know they're gonna get opportunities from, and they act like we don't all talk together and we all not gonna find out about these type of things. Now, when you do those type of things, am I supposed to remain silent? Or is that unprofessional and uncredible because you're only helping certain children and not helping all the kids? I'm just saying. They probably won't see this, okay? There's gonna be probably a lot of pissed off people by this video. But to be honest with you, I'm just stating facts. What I do on YouTube does not discredit my ability to be the shit in person, okay? Does not discredit what I do. Me cursing, does that mean I'm less qualified to do a job? No, it does not. Does that mean I'm a bad person because I curse up a motherfucking storm? It does not. People curse every day, B. It just is not broadcasted all damn day. Unless you're some type of damn priest. Sorry, maybe that shouldn't be in the same sentence. Unless you're a priest or something, I'm sure priests curse. You just don't see them. Point is, I'm not a fan of people telling me to tone it down. Don't tell me shit. Don't tell me shit I already know. Don't tell me shit. What do you want?
You gotta say comment down.
No, I'm really mad. So for someone to tell me that my work is incredible and unprofessional, that bothers me. Like, at least if you say I'm unprofessional, okay, I'll get it, but don't call my work unprofessional or incredible. I spend hours upon hours upon hours putting my content together. I spend a lot of time. I spend a shitload of time putting my content together to entertain you guys, to build my platform, to make myself a better content creator. So when someone tries to tell me that I'm not doing a good job at that because I curse, that's bullshit. All right, that's bullshit, 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 bullshit. So long story short, I don't even need you to read y'all the rest. He got upset. I don't know. Wish me good things in the future, whatever. Honestly, at the end of the day, I'm gonna get it with or without anyone, whether anyone helps me or not. And I'm gonna continue to be me no matter what. If you do not like what I do, if you do not like the fact that I curse up a storm, do not follow me, do not subscribe to me, do not fuck with me. Like, it's real easy, like, just don't.
not trying to be something that I'm not. So if I'm not fitting your little vision, your little shiznits, then I'm just not. Like, I don't know what to tell you. I'm incredible and unprofessional. I'm sorry, y'all. That shit will always, that shit really bothers me. But whatever. Let me know what y'all think down in the comment section down below. I'm gonna keep this series up. That means it's probably gonna be a shitload of uploads because I really love to talk about shit like this. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Like, share, subscribe, do all that. Peace.